to another week. Right, this week, I'm just gonna concentrate on what it's like in the Sophie T Arp studio, warehouse, whatever you wanna bloody call it. Even though we don't have specifically a show on or anything to work towards, it's still busy all the time. Like, there's still so many projects going on, and also some of the difficulties we're finding with our scaling up of everything. I'll take you in. There's so much stuff like buzzing around in my head, so I'll take you around and yeah, we'll see. All right, so I kind of figured out the other day that I've probably bought anywhere between 5,000 and 8,000 ready-made canvases. So when I first started, obviously I was just like going around the art shops and seeing what the cheapest canvas there was on the market, and I was getting that one. And or I was using paper because obviously it was cheaper. However, like, you know, as we started getting more orders, like obviously your goal as an artist is to just use the best materials because like that's all the fun. So at every single stage we've been like always upgrading the quality of everything. So much so about a year ago I upgraded to like the best quality canvas you could possibly buy, which meant that I would have them all professionally made and stretched. Then I was like, fuck, we're just spending so much money on creating these canvases. We need to bring this in the house. Now I've obviously got this massive place. So introducing Rumor, pro canvas stretcher. She learned how to stretch about 2 weeks ago. How many have you done, would you say? 70 in 2 weeks. Yeah, she's building some great muscle strength. One thing that we did not consider actually is how bloody loud it would be. Like, echoes through the entire warehouse. Listen. Oh, another thing as well, like obviously, I sound like a fucking bitch because I'm telling you that you did a shit job in front of you, but like the first 10, the first 10 were baggier. Because Rima just didn't pull them tight enough, but it's all good, it's fine, it's fine. Anyway, so we're, and then we painted on them and then we realised that the canvas is a bit baggy, so it's gonna restretch. Just as funny, isn't it? Like, if you do anything enough times, you just become a professional at it. Right, okay. I'm finishing my commissions off now. I stopped taking them around 6 months ago, maybe a bit longer actually. I've got the final probably 20 to go. Love this one. This is like a muted pink coloured one. Obviously that's a long way off. This one, however, but yeah, she gave me options. She goes, Sophie can decide whether to include my tattoos or not. And obviously, like, because I'm annoying, I was like, I love the fucking challenge. Like, I'll do your tattoos. And now I'm just like, shit, can't work them out. It's not leaving this studio until it's perfect, but I think it's gonna be a while. So another project we're working on. My next drop actually in, not this Sunday, but the Sunday after, will be a double heart print. So colors, my mum basically, when I did my entire Nudie Women collection, there was one, I don't know whether you remember, it was like a big peach, smaller girl, it was like a side angle, small boobs, kind of like me to be honest. My mum was like, so for the colours on that, you need to replicate it, you need to do that again. So, this is for my mum. I've decided to do two kind of like quite neutral colour sets and bringing in the peach and monochromes in there, and I'm gonna make this mainly monochrome and then add some peach. I might actually add a pop of orange, not sure yet, gonna see how I feel. I quite like them, even though they've only had like 30 minutes work so far, but feel good about these. So right, me and Ella, we're having this brainstorm about where we want the brand to sit next. So, I've got the concept for the next project. I think I know what it's gonna say. And then we were gonna take the colors on a more muted place, but nah, fuck that. So this is an indication of how crazy we're gonna be going. Like, the shock is gonna be like, oh, you know we did color before, it's gonna be more, sorry. So I'm super excited for these guys. So I've been working on these small original pieces. So this is gonna be another drop, and I think it's gonna be in about a month or 2 months time, so a long way off. It's gonna take me ages to finish them. But I really feel like now that we're like creating this like very like premium luxury brand, we need to like let the customers know at every single contact point that we care about them, whether that's from like buying the best materials, investing in stretching them in-house, getting these boxes like fucking sick. So basically, it's like we are creating the best possible experience for our customer. Okay, so holographic prints. Oh my God, it has been a process. We started the journey 10 months ago. I had this idea that I wanted to create a piece of artwork that was super shiny, had those holographic qualities. So that's what I want, all very well and good. Oh, don't get run over. Look around all the suppliers. No one had this specific film. Found out that this random business somewhere was closing down and they had one roll of this holographic film left. So I was like, fuck yeah, snap that up right now. Then we needed to find a supplier that had this special cylinder drum type thing that can heat the holographic film and lay it onto our limited edition print, right? Samples confirmed this weren't good enough. Like, there was just like some tiny imperfections in it. Anyway, so I was stressed because I've already bloody sold the prints because I thought they were fine, and then I looked up close and they weren't fine. I'm just like, shit, I'm gonna have to do a big product recall. This is the worst thing ever. But apparently, the issue has been solved because we were trying to adhere the film at 124 degrees when in fact that needed to be at 94 degrees, which is like unheard of in the film adhering world. So apparently all of that has been fixed and they're inside now. I'm pretty nervous, but yeah, let's go take a look. Hello. So these are all of our frames that have been made. Hello, 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 hello. Okay, that's good. I'm happy with that, thank God. Yeah, perfect. When things are going bad, oh my God, all I wanna do is just like, get back and paint, hey? Thank God that print is looking good now. Right, let's go. My new direction is not gonna require as much painting. So I'm just trying to lap it all up now. Get it all out of my system. I stopped painting abstract work to move on to nudes. And one of the main reasons was because it was just absolutely killing my back. I was like bent over all the time, like pouring these huge works. And now my hands are starting to hurt because I'm painting so pretty much. So give myself a bit of a break from that as well. Feel like I'm getting old, hey? There's like such inspirational messages on this. And then there's, I think that's a good thing. They say in Australia, like, yeah, you're a good cunt. Like it's a good thing. Very confusing. I'm always like, oh, terrible. I've got a potty mouth anyway, but like as soon as the C word comes into it. That's nice. This print is being released in 2 weeks' time. So I'm ahead of schedule. Also, Nicole is on my back for making sure things are done in a timely fashion. And I respect her because I think she's fab. So I'm doing as I'm told. Ooh, also had a beer. All right, okay, I think I'm done. I've given all of my creative energy to this now, so I'm gonna leave. I'm also an auntie for the first time, which is very exciting. So I'm about to go and see my baby niece and I don't want to be late for her. So goodbye. Goodbye. I love you like la 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 la. Thanks so much, guys. Make sure you like and subscribe the channel. Also, I really want to say thanks for all the comments on the nudie catwalk video. We love reading through them. And yeah, the winner has been chosen for that little competition that we did. So yeah, mwah. Love you, bye. Hello, hello. Is it me or...